News Channel 5 at 6, back tonight with our Will It Work series, this time around the iPad. You know, some reviews are calling it more than a product. It is a statement, an idea, and potentially a prime mover, they say, in the world of consumer electronics.
That's some high praise. A bit overwhelming to say all that, yeah. But there's also quite a bit of criticism towards Apple's newest product. News Channel 5's Mary Morin tests it out with a local New York Times best-selling novelist.
The iPad. It's said to be the dawn of a new class of multimedia device. Promoted as magical and revolutionary, we asked award-winning novelist and iPhone user Chris Bohjalian to see if the iPad is as spectacular and life-changing as it's said to be.
That wasn't difficult. Let's see if there's an iBook app somewhere. Yes, there's iBooks. Let's go right there.
On the iPad, the books sit right on their own virtual shelf.
As a novelist, I always like to look at books.
And they open up with a simple touch of the cover.
And we open to chapter 10. That's always where I begin my books.
Despite that detail, the pages flip flawlessly. And if you need to, you can increase the font size.
There we go.
And Apple seems to target every age on the iPad.
Ah, I grew up with these books.
There is Beezus. No, Ramona. That's Ramona.
Well, you can easily find Beverly Cleary's books. Unfortunately, you can't find Bohjalian's novels on the iBooks app. As of early May, Apple and Random House still don't have an agreement.
It's times like this that I wish my name were Dan Brown.
And you probably won't see Bohjalian's full website on the iPad either. In fact, you probably won't even be able to watch this Will It Work on our website. That's because the iPad doesn't easily mesh with Flash. It can load many other things like YouTube and TV episodes such as 30 Rock.
And it even has last Thursday's episode already on here.
And typing in the names of other shows and movies you're looking to find is easy.
I have to say, I mean, the feel of it is pretty good.
But my first email wasn't exactly flawless. Bohjalian said, though, it's much easier to type on than the iPhone.
But, I mean, essentially the iPad is an iPhone on steroids.
The device does pack some surprises.
I actually had no idea that it had something like this on here.
Maps with 360-degree views and an iPad photo album.
I now carry most photographs of my wife and my daughter and my cats on my iPhone. And I can see that in the same way you'd use this device the same way.
You can make your own captions and add effects.
That was like the avatar effect.
You can even make your own music.
Anagata DeVita, Iron Butterfly.
And then there are the games.
There we go. That's
nicely
neat.
Nicely done.
But do some of the widely noted shortcomings of the iPad bother Bohjalian?
The fact there's no Flash on this is a drag.
The lack of a webcam doesn't bother him, and neither does the lack of a USB port. However, the novelist says he won't be writing any novels or columns on the iPad the way it is now, and he still loves to read books on paper. But he does think it is a game changer.
I would not be surprised if in 5 or 10 years, this has replaced the laptop computer. You can do everything on it. It's lighter. It's fun to use. It's got this great aesthetic that's just a delight.
With Will It Work, Mary Morin, News Channel 5.
Makes you want one, doesn't it? Well, the iPad starts at $500, and if you really want to stay connected, you can get it with Wi-Fi and 3G.